Look at this guy right here. Look, we got a wyvern. Okay. All right. Please be good. Please be good level.
What is up, the world? What is up, the world?
It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things, playing some more Skies of Nazca, vanilla stuff and things. Hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a great day. Thanks so much for coming to hang out with me today. Make sure if you like the video. Oh, I'm gonna die. Please don't forget to show your support. Smash the thumbs up button. If you're new and you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe. Eat. Oh my god, so cold. And it got so super cold super fast. Go down. Stop being cold. It wasn't cold just a second ago. Oh, get out of there. Why is it so cold suddenly? No, don't die. Yes, we did it. We survived. Oh, the cold on this map is so it's just awful. Oh. So anyway, you may have seen the reason that I brought you guys out here. Like I was saying, thanks for coming to hang out with me today. There are wyverns. I was talking about in the last episode, we did an exploratory episode. We needed an entire episode just to see everything that was on the map. Is this the regular Gamma again? Yeah, this is it. This is as bright as it really is. So anyway, we needed an entire episode just to explore everything that was on this crazy map. I mean, we went up to all these weird islands, looking for cool places to make bases. I think that I know where it is that I want to build, but I know that I hadn't explored over here. So after I was done recording the other episode, I popped over and I noticed that there was a wyvern over here. And I didn't want to explore without you guys, so I decided to bring you guys back over so we could see what's going on. There you can see one right there. Is it too far away for me to see its deal? It is too far away. That's obviously a fire wyvern. Now, I have looked around when I saw these guys. I looked around really quickly to see, pardon me. I got a Beelzebub in my throat. To see if I could see any nests. It's only level 32. Oh, not again. No. Go back. Oh my God, so cold. Oh, no, don't die. Ethan, we have no more food. Why is it so cold here? Oh my God, it's so cold. It's a friggin' desert. Okay, we've got to get back to the base. The air quotes base. It looks like we can't do any more exploring over there. So, couple of things. For this series, if we're going to continue on this freaking island, how's our stamina doing? We're doing great on stamina. So if we're going to continue the series on this island, number one thing, fortitude. We need fortitude. Definitely more than 20. Number two thing, fur armor. We absolutely are going to need that. And if we want to get into getting a wyvern egg, if we're going to do that... Whoa, what is that? What the frick is that? That's the Basilosaurus. I haven't seen one yet. It's like a huge porpoise. It's amazing looking. And yes, trolls, I know that it's porpoise. I was just trying to make a joke. You need to learn how to be funny like me. All right, so anyway, can we survive right here? Oh my God. So we haven't done any work on the knot base that we don't have. I think I'm going to go ahead and get just like some foundations placed. I might try to pick some of these up and put them back down. I'm not sure how that's gonna work out. We still have all of our resources, which is really, really good information. It's really, really lucky that we do. Not good information. But here you can see we've got a bunch of resources, so we shouldn't have a hard time doing a ton of building. Oh, wait, nothing? Wait, seriously? Oh, did we lose? Oh, I think we lost a couple. There's our raptor egg. I think we lost a couple of our storage deals that were back here that had some building materials in them. We still got our bed, though. I don't know if we can spawn into that bed. So, anywho, here's a couple of things. Fortitude, fur armor, obviously we need a base place. Getting a wyvern is a super high priority as well, if that is a possibility. On top of that, if we are going to do this, I have leveled up. By the way, I don't think I told you in the last episode, Grumpy, it was level 104 when I tamed it up, and I think it tamed out at 150-something. But I've been pumping melee damage to 1,000. I got 5,000 HPs on this guy. I think I put a point into stamina, and I've been pumping just movement speed. Now, if I remember correctly, in order to outrun a wyvern, if we want to outrun one, I think on the RG you need to have like 200 or 205% movement speed. Obviously, it's going to depend on the wyvern level, I think. That changes things a little bit. I think it does for the NPCs. I'm not 100% sure. You know what? We got a level. Oh, I really need these to be at 200. But that's not our main priority. Right now, we got to pump a little bit of fortitude. So, yeah, those are the priorities that we're going to have to kind of, like, accomplish to move on this map. It's kind of, like, this is, like, vanilla plus. Even though we've got, like, structures plus in here to help us out a little bit. Oh, I'm too fat. Sorry about that. I didn't mean Reginald Barclay. I didn't mean to crush your hopes and dreams. Perhaps we would pump weight a touch. No, melee damage. So, yeah, this is kind of like vanilla plus. Like, it's vanilla, but it's also even harder. It's almost a cross between, like, scorched earth and vanilla with great heights. So, yeah, those are all the stuff and things that we need to get done in order to move forward with our playthrough on this map. I'm going to start getting some stuff done, peeps. I will be BRBs. And we're back, and I got to show you something, guys. So, I'm pretty sure the reason why the Structures Plus got removed is because I know there was a big, big update, or I heard that there was an update. I didn't realize what was going on with it, but I know that there was some pretty cool stuff and things that got added. So if you take a look here at S Plus now, like, so you can see, let me see if I can show you some of the stuff that's super cool and new that I don't think was in the mod before. So I don't know if the repair gun was in the mod. I think it was, actually. The S Plus item collector? I'm not even sure exactly what this does. Collects dropped items. Poop, achatina paste, eggs, etc. It looks like it just collects a bunch of stuff. They added in. I'm pretty sure there wasn't an S Plus storage deal before. And then there's also this metal box now. S Plus vault. But this thing, the transfer gun got added. And I got to show you this thing, guys. It's unbelievable. So here you can see this guy is... There's nothing in there. What do we got? We got stuff and things in here. We got stuff and things in here. So I've got some foundation set of just to remake the base. I moved the campfires over. I don't really know if we should maybe make S Plus campfires now. I don't know if they're better, but this is the deal. Check this out. If we right click on this guy and then we left click on this guy, bam, moved all the items. Now that I think can't be stopped. I don't have to move things, a million things, and then click, 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 click. I love it. This is the best thing that's ever happened in the history of right now. Bam, all these guys. Nail the days to keep you stop. They're done. We don't even need them anymore. Let's go ahead and grab the demo gun. We'll squirt this guy out like so. And a bam and a bam and a bam. And then a bam and a bam. We're going to move those guys down too. So we got all this extra stuff now we don't really need. The large storage boxes and the regular storage. I mean, maybe we could use them somewhere for something. There's our bed. There's a couple of these guys. Let's go ahead and grab our bed. Let's put this away. And let's put this bed down. Doesn't matter where it goes. This looks like a great spot. And not so great. Yeah, right here. Ish. Perfect. So just get that down there as the utility bed. So I wanted to show you the transfer gun while I was moving to some things. Also, you can see these guys are a little bit off because the S plus storage boxes don't have any clipping. So you can't really tell. Normally, when you're placing storage next to each other, you place it and the next one shows the outline in red and you move until you can place it and you place it again and they're just nice and perfectly even. Well, these you can't tell. So I don't know. It's just like you can place them inside of each other, which is kind of interesting. I don't know how that would work out, but we still need crafting station, refining forges, a bunch of different stuff. Things. I just want to show you the transfer gun. I'm going to keep working it out. BRB's peeps. And we are back. Stuff and things are happening, peeps. I got some just wood in these fires burning up for charcoal. I've made some hot narcotics action to replenish our supplies. We have some gasoline being crafted and created over in this area like a so. We have our fabricator up in this piece as well. I built the S Plus crafting table. We have our smithy with some stuff and things inside of here. So, that's kind of the deal. I'm going to squirt the rest of that inside of there. Actually, you know what? No. Give me this right here. Give me that right there. We're going to squirt that into this guy right here. And then we'll just put some of these talons inside of this deal like so. We don't need quite this many arrows on us. So, I'm going to take these guys and squirt them inside of there. We can combine those like so. All right. So we're doing pretty good. Now, metal. So what I decided to do with our metal fabrication is why run the raw metal all the way from over here where Lieutenant Commander Data is and run all the way back to the base. So I built a little refining forge area deal right over here. It's far enough away so that stuff and things will respawn if need be, but not too far away because it does take a second for to run things over here. I got a bunch of metal inside of here getting crafted up. So we're going to go ahead and grab this. I think I'm going to have to bring some more wood or get some more wood to bring down. How's our, yeah, we're doing good on the weight. Like so, and like so. So we're going to grab all that, get on to Grumpy, and then check it out over here. So yeah, Lieutenant Commander Data, he is hanging out. I think he's still got a bunch of metal on him too. And I just want to make sure that he is on neutral. Oh my God. There's way too much stuff inside of here. So he is on neutral. All right. So yeah, you can see we've got some stone in there, a bunch of metal still. I'm just pumping his weight only. That is the major thing that we need on him. But he's doing his thing over there like that. All right, next order of business. I want to see if we can get a Wyvern. I don't know if there is... Oh, yeah, we need fur armor, too. So we got to think about that. We could probably get the 7 things that we need to make fur armor while we're doing other things. So, yeah, in order to get over there and get out of there in a timely fashion, we're going to need a super fast something flyer. I was thinking about using teleporters, too, but I don't know. They're kind of expensive and all that. So it's going to take a lot of movement points in order to get this guy high enough. So what I thought we would do is just look for a really high-level Pteranodon. So let's go ahead and squirt that inside of there. Yeah, and then we'll put this little spoiled meat deal right here. We just got the one. Make me some more stuff and things. Now that it came stuff. So I want to go over here where I had seen all these Pteranodons. There was a bunch right over in this area. We need a really high level one, preferably over level 100. I think it was right over here that I saw a few of them. Are they not here? Oh, there's one. Okay. Let's see what we got going on here. We need to get a Dodick, too. Are you a high-level DD? Double D? No. 16. You suck. Oh, you look quick. 32. No, you're dumb. All right. So that's what we want to do. I want to just get a really high-level Pteranodon and just pump speed on it. Like, just worry about speed. We don't need it for anything but outrunning Wyvern Wyverns, if that's the case. 16. Of course. There's nothing here. But we are seeing some spawns at the very least. So I'm going to have a fly around here, see what we can find. And I will be your beast, peeps! And we're back. I think we got it, guys. It's not under over 100, but it's a 96. Wait, 96? Okay, Bola. Really, really quick.
What? Nailed it, Ace, the game stopped.
Wait, no, this, quickly. Okay, so we're gonna try to get this guy down. One, we're just gonna hammer him. He's down. That was quick. All right, sweet. Oh my God, it was so easy. I'm surprised it was so easy to get him down. I'm excited about that. I think we probably should have some... Oh, 38 minutes? Okay, we've got a good long timers on our prime meats. We're going to squirt it inside of our guy right here like so. So he should be good to go. We got our Pteranodon. Now we just got to level him up. And then, like I was saying, I think we're going to level up. I mean, a little bit. We're going to need a little bit of melee damage. Also, look at this place. I did a whole lap of the map. Like, I did a lap out there in the last episode. But I didn't really come into the center. There's a whole river that comes through here that comes over to these spire things. That, the other side of these spire things are where the base area place is. This map is massive. Because I went around the outside, I never went around the inside. So I never really saw this place. So anyway, pardonnez-moi. Yeah. Whoa. Oh, compies. No, maybe we should just, like, do like this, and then we'll just, yep, you're just a little compy over here, and you're dead. Sorry. Wait, you're dead now. Is there another one? Yeah, get this guy right here. So, anywho, I just haven't really seen the entire map yet, so I'm always constantly seeing some sort of, like, new spot or new place, which I think is cool. Another thing that I'm finding is that it seems like the dinos are really, really spread out. Like, in a really, really strange way. Like, I flew all around the coast around there, found this river, came all the way down through inside of here and found this guy. But you can see there's, like, hardly anything else in the area. Like, there's one dodo, two dodos. There's a couple Beelzebufos over there. Down there towards the mouth of the river, there was more stuff. Anyway, the point being is that it seems like the dinos are really, really spread out. So, it makes it a little bit harder to find some things. But that's just the way of the world. So, all right. Oh, probably going to need to grab some berries. Looks like this guy's going to take a minute to tame up. We're going to get him up, get him back to base, get a saddle on him, get him leveled up. I'm probably going to do all that stuff off camera. I'm trying to accelerate the process for you guys a little bit because it seems like every episode's like one step forward, two steps back because of weird stuff and things that are going on. So I want to make a little bit of progress. So I'm just going to get a bunch of stuff done and I will be our beast, peeps. Hey, we're back in the rainy wee morning hours with Civic. So, he ended up getting hit by a friggin' Dello, and his taming effectiveness went down to, like, 76%. So, we only ended up getting, like, 38 levels, I think, or something like that. But, I leveled the crap out of him, and we've got him up to 1,900 HPs. I didn't pump his HPs very much at all. 1,100 stamina. I put some points into this. I actually put quite a few points into melee damage. I got his movement speed up to 205. Now, if I'm not mistaken, the base movement speed on a Pteranodon is way faster than it is on a RG, I think. I've never really tested what the deal is with these as far as outrunning Wyverns on a Pteranodon. When we played Scorched Earth, what was that? Oh, it's just a Megalodon. When we played Scorched Earth, we always did it on RGs. So I just kind of want... Oh, you know what? Berserk, we got to turn it back around. Crap, I totally forgot about one part of our plan. We had a whole plan that we planned, and I didn't plan out the whole plan. So I want to test this guy out. He doesn't have a ton of stamina. This might be a little bit sketchy, but I completely forgot that I've got to go get wool so I can make, or pelt, pardon me, so I can make our wool armor, our fur armor. I haven't even done that yet. He's pretty damn quick. I think he's going to be fast enough. But before that, I don't think I even have any pelt at all. I've been saving all my stuff and things. You can see I've got a ton of regular hide in here, but we don't have any pelt. So I'm pretty sure I know I can get some pretty quick. There are some wolves and stuff and things around. Maybe we could head over into that biome. Anyway, I'll get the pelt and I'll get the full armor. We'll have a BRBs, but at least you get to know what's going on with the Pteranodon. And we're back. And we're ice cubed again. 0 degrees Fahrenheit. We've got our fur armor on. I've got my fortitude pumped to 26. And yeah, we're still ice cubed. It doesn't seem like we're dying quite as quickly as before. Are you going to get peeved at me? Okay, we're surviving a bit. Like, a bit. So, what we've got to try to figure out is there's wyvern spawns, but are there wyvern eggs? That was the whole idea of doing this. Was to see if there were wyvern eggs around anywhere. What's this over here? Okay, that's just that other floating island deal. We're just trying to see if there's any nests around. So, oh man, I'm super cold already. Let me see if I can eat a little bit. We might need to like craft up some of the brews or something like that in order to get this to happen. Oh, this looks like a really bad idea. Is there anything bad on the other? I expected to come out inside of like a freaking wyvern cavern or some deal like that. No, it doesn't look like there's anything up there. And then I know all the way at the top, I don't believe there are any... I don't think there was anything up here. Let's go up here and see real quick. God, I could just look it up and see if there are any wyvern nests on this map or not, but it's kind of fun to explore around and see what you can find out. Okay, that's like a hole of death. Don't fall inside of there. I remember being up here, there were no nests, right? No, I don't see any. Okay, we're getting to... Whoa, what's up there, man? Oh, there's all sorts of stuff and things. There's a little lake deal. I'm just concerned that at some moment, we're gonna, like, get accosted by a huge amount of wyverns. It doesn't look like that's the case. We really can't survive for too long up here. There's crystal. Do you guys see any nests? I don't see any. Crap! I was so hoping that we'd find a wyvern nest up here. How's our HPs doing? Okay, I'm gonna do some more searching around, but for right now, I've gotta head out. I've gotta get out of here because it's way, 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 way too cold. I may give up. Oh no, we're in deep trouble. Ooh, we're losing health super fast. Oh, baby. Okay. Eat a little bit more. Oh, we're out of stamina. Oh, no, this is bad. Okay, we're not going to die from being cold. Can we please make it over here to land? Ooh, no. Oh, okay. Okay. Oh, we're going to land in a really bad place. Oh, this is not good. Oh, this is not good. We are going to land in a super terrible place. Do you have food even? Oh, he doesn't even have any food on him. Crap, I dropped all the stuff and things because I wanted to drop weight. Oh, do we get off the wing? This is going to be so terrible. Okay. Oh, what are we going to do? Okay, let's see what we can do. No. Just land. Okay, you got to land, guy. You've got to land. What are we going to do? Okay, ready? Watch this. E. J. Oh my god, it kicked my butt. It broke my legs. Okay, it's over. No, pick me up, pick me up. No, we died and our guy is up. No, what is this? This is so wild. This game hates me. And we're back. This is a cool little spot though. So, thankfully I dropped basically everything that I had in order to lower weight. I was worried that I wasn't going to have enough weight to be able to carry the egg because the Civic... I named him Civic, by the way, because he's not super fast, but we can soup him up to make him fast. Like a lot of people soup up their Honda Civics. But yeah, I was concerned. There he is right there. Okay. So we could just come over here. And all I had on there was the fur armor. That's the only thing that's in my bag. So, follow me, homie. I think we're just going to leave the armor. I think we're just going to leave that armor and get in GTFO. No, you need to stop being like that. God, he's super fast. He's so fast. Maybe we'll switch. It'd probably be the best idea here. Can we come up here and land? And then... follow me. Stop following me. Oh, crap. Okay, there we go, like so. Then you can follow the Civic. All right, so... now we can head back to base. We can maybe build some more fur armor. I'll have to go get some more pelt. But at this point, I'm a little bit done with the wondering if there are nests. I think I'm going to head over to the Sons of Nazca page and see if there are actually nests here. And we're back. More fur armor, ready to rock and roll. And I was up here doing some stuff and things. I went to the page and was reading about whether or not there were... I don't have my spyglass. I was going to show you something with my spyglass that I think I can see over there. I think that I can see it. But yeah, people are saying that there are a very, very limited amount of nests. So I think this is one right here. Yep, it is. I thought I could see the egg from far away. Look at this guy right here. Look, we got a wyvern! Okay. All right, please be good. Please be good level. Please be good level. So there's people that are posting coordinates in the chat as to where they are. And most of the coordinates, I mean, I don't know. I can't really tell what's going on. The map is incorrect, so it doesn't really matter. But we got this guy. What? Level 32? That's terrible. It's too cold here for it. I haven't picked it up yet, but it already has a spoil timer. I didn't know that that was a thing. All right, we're just going to grab it. I don't think there's any... Whoa, go. I don't think there's any wyverns that are going to come after us. So, yeah, I'm thinking we should be able to come back whenever we want. We didn't even need to get the Super Pteranodon guy. We could have just, like, done this however we wanted to do it. So, yeah, like I was saying, on the page, some people were saying they were posting where there were coordinates. I was trying to check out kind of where I thought it might be. It didn't really work out. Basically, what is this guy doing up here? What are you doing up here, Moth? You crazy Moth with brainworms? They were saying look around where the wyverns are and... yeah, I don't know. There's no wyvern up there by that one. There is a wyvern over here. I'm a little bit concerned. How much weight do we got? Okay, it's not that heavy. It weighs 50. Our stamina's doing all right. So you'd think there would be one, and our health is doing all right too, even though we're cold. Oh yeah, I can't make Freya curry, by the way, either, which I could have to, well, what? Where did he go? Okay, there he is. I could have made Freya curry. I can make it. I mean, it's makeable, but, I don't have any of the stuff and things. I don't have any of the vegetables. We're not there yet. Also, look at this guy over here. What is this friggin' titanosaur doing? It's a Submariner titanosaur guy. So, I really wish I'd have brought my... I didn't want to bring anything with me because I didn't want to die. I really wish I would have now at least brought my spyglass with me. So, I'm thinking there's probably another nest over here somewhere. There's got to be... page also says that the nests, there are nests on top of there. They're on top of that tower right there with the weird deals. There are no nests up there. That is a big fat lie. Wow, we're not losing any HPs at all. This is awesome. Let me see here. We just must not be that cold. Oh wait, that was the guy. We're losing it a little bit. No. Is it like perfection right now? Oh yeah. Okay. It's getting warmer. All right. Sweet. So I'm thinking there must be a nest down here. I know it's not going to spawn in until I get a little bit closer. Oh, I just got to keep my eyes peeled for that wyvern. There's just like stuff and things around here. Where's that guy? I'm so worried that wyvern's going to like come squirting up over the edge there and it's going to annihilate us. No, he's down over there now. He's just landed. He's just chillaxing. Well, I'm going to have a little bit of a look around a little bit further. I feel like I really need to pay attention to what I'm looking at. And I'm thinking there's got to be, if there was one nest, I mean, there's got to be more. But at the very least, we have one egg now. Even though it's a low level, I guess it's better than nothing, right? And we are back, heading back to base. So I found out some pretty interesting information. First and foremost, during the day after around 9 a.m., We are able to go up there in our fur armor, and it ain't no big thing. So this is good to know. This is definitely good to know. Let's take all this, squirt all this off, and then let's squirt all this stuff, all of our items back into our inventories here. Squirt, 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 squirt. You. And I think that's going to be it. So yeah, it's really good to know that during that part of the day, I could probably go up there without much of a problem. It seemed a little bit weird, because I remember the last couple of times I went up there, I think it was, I don't know, during like a normal time. Not exactly sure. What's the timer despawn on this? 39 hours? We're going in there. 159 years. So anyhoozle, yes, if we go up there during the day, we can search around. Now, I searched around for a long, long time. I searched around. I don't even know how long it's been. I'm trying to look down the clock. Almost 2 hours? I've just went, no. Hour and a half. Flying around up top there, flying around all around there. And then with the presumption that where there are wyverns' nests, I don't know if I can really believe that because I found that one on the very top up there, all the way on the up, let's go like one of these, all the way up there, and there's no wyverns up there. So that's where I found this nest. So yeah, and I don't know if there's predetermined spots or how this whole deal works. I went all over into that area past this mountain, into the flat area there a bit. And there were wyverns over there, and it was kind of wooded and foresty, and there were wyverns flying around. I flew all around inside of there. There were no nests there either. And like I was saying, I was reading on the page, it said there are nests up here, and there are not. There are, or they haven't spawned in or something like that. So I'm not sure how the map maker is doing it on this map. I definitely wanted to get into a better wyvern than this. But I think, yeah, I don't know. I can check. I can check for... for nests here and there while I'm doing stuff and things. But that's going to be it for today, peeps. I got to tell you what. We got a new pteranodon. We found a wyvern egg. We rebuilt our broken base. And yeah, stuff and things happened. But yeah, I'm excited. I want to find a better wyvern, but we got to get a better base going. We got to get, what else is I'm trying to think of? Plants? We got to get vegetables? All sorts of stuff and things need to happen. Thanks so much for coming to hang out with me today, guys. Make sure if you like the video, please don't forget, show your support and smash the thumbs up button. Feel free to share and favorite the video as you see fit. And may the stuff and things be with you.